Hello everyone, Newborn Investor here and welcome to another video. Today we are gonna go through my thoughts on Workhorse and the reasons why I will not be a buyer of Workhorse at this time. So if you're interested, make sure to stick around as we are starting right now. Workhorse Group, the Ohio-based electric vehicle manufacturer, has seen its stock continue to move up over the past couple of weeks amid a general euphoria surrounding electric vehicles. The stock is up a whopping 600% year to date. With the current price levels, the company has an astronomical valuation of $1.5 billion despite making less than $100,000 in revenue last quarter. In the case of Workhorse, I see some potential red flags which are drawing me back from investing in the company. So what are they? Well, that's exactly what we are going to cover in this video, so stay tuned. By the way, if you like the video and find it valuable, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button. I really appreciate your support. Founded in 2007, Workhorse Group is a technology company focused on providing sustainable and cost-effective drone-integrated electric vehicles to the last-mile delivery sector. Workhorse is the first mover and the only US pure-play original equipment manufacturer in medium-duty electrification for last delivery vehicles. At first, the focus was on developing electric vehicles with two-seat roadsters, but the company eventually pivoted to create trucks and vans for commercial purposes with special focus on last-mile delivery vehicles. Workhorse has been getting a lot of attention this year, and that can be mostly attributed to the much-anticipated USPS contract. USPS started requesting proposals for replacing its current fleet of aged delivery vehicles with next-generation delivery vehicles back in 2015. The deal in its entirety is worth over $8 billion, and Workhorse is among the three bidders left. The contract was supposed to be awarded on October 13, but investors would have to wait until the end of this year to know who gets the contract. As a result, shares of Workhorse took a dive and many analysts started downgrading the electric truck maker. Against the hopes of many optimistic investors, on October 8, short seller Fessy Panda Research issued a report in which it stated that it believes that Workhorse has no chance of winning a huge deal to provide USPS with new vehicles. Obviously, the short seller would benefit big time if the contract slips out of Workhorse and if the stock tumbles. As an unbiased investor, I never blindly follow short seller reports as they always have their interest first. I went through the report in detail and some of the allegations raised by Fessy Panda stood out. But before getting into the details, one of the first questions that came to my mind was that why hasn't Workhorse responded to any of the short seller allegations yet? As a public company, do you think Workhorse is liable to come up with a factual and detailed response to the short seller allegations? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Okay, now back to certain key points in the short seller report. According to Fessy Panda, VT Hackney was the prime contract bidder in the VT Hackney Workhorse USPS bid. The short seller alleges that Hackney's parent company, ST Engineering, exited the bid for the USPS program in 2019 because any award would not be material. VT Hackney exited the partnership by selling Hackney's assets and bidding rights to Workhorse for $7.6 million. So why in the world would a large conglomerate like ST Engineering sell the rights to a large contract? The short seller says that the real reason behind the exit was due to the critical failures in VT Hackney Workhorse prototypes. The report even calls out an incident where the USPS prototype truck rolled down a hill after its parking brake failed, causing a USPS driver to be hospitalized. Of course, this happened during testing, but do you think that this incident would have strained their relationship with USPS? Also, without VT Hackney, could Workhorse deliver on the contract if they get it? Well, I will leave the answer to you. According to Fessy Panda, UPS is no longer interested in getting vehicles from Workhorse. Instead, UPS has moved on to Workhorse's competitor Arrival, a UK-based electric vehicle company. Prior to Arrival, UPS had an initial order of 50 trucks with Workhorse, which was delivered in the first quarter of 2018. Following this initial delivery, Workhorse received an additional order from UPS for 950 trucks. The short seller alleges that this follow-up order is on demand basis and calls out Workhorse in failing to mention this nature of the contract. The report also states that Workhorse has not received any on-demand orders from UPS in years. The short seller questions the production capabilities of Workhorse. During a Workhorse production site visit, Fuzzy Panda investigator discovered no automation, no assembly lines, and absolutely no intellectual property protection. The short seller also claims to have interviewed some Workhorse employees during the visit. The employees revealed that there were absolutely no purchase orders that were being fulfilled, and the trucks displayed in the plant were only prototypes. On another note, Workhorse recently acquired a 10% stake in Lordstown Motors, giving Workhorse access to its production capabilities. But is that enough to fulfill the USPS order? Workhorse has also entered into an agreement with Hitachi America and Hitachi Capital America Corporation. Workhorse will be paying Hitachi consulting fees to assess the improvements it needs to make at its two production facilities to produce trucks. On the other hand, Hitachi Capital agreed to provide financing for Workhorse's customers and dealers. This part of the agreement comes into play only if Workhorse is actually able to produce trucks. So, will Workhorse be able to implement all the suggestions from Hitachi? What if the suggestions require additional cash and Workhorse is unable to secure the needed funds? Well, we have to wait and see. The short seller in their report compares Workhorse founder Steve Burns to Trevor Milton, the founder of Nikola. The short seller calls out Steve Burns as a copycat entrepreneur who mimics ideas, misleads investors, and for decades has destroyed investor capital. Fuzzy Panda also alleges that Steve Burns has a long history of partnering with stock promoters, thereby pumping up stock prices. The short seller raises numerous other allegations, but I thought these were the main ones. If you're interested in knowing more, I will post a link to the article in the description below. Now, what's my take on Workhorse? To form my opinion, I would completely rely on the financials of the company. As a conservative investor, the idea of a company relying mostly on one contract scares the hell out of me. The balance sheet of Workhorse doesn't look good to me as they have much more liabilities than cash and assets. To overcome this cash deficit, Workhorse has been in a spree to secure funding. Last week, Workhorse closed a $200 million funding transaction, but this does not come for free. Workhorse raised this cash by issuing convertible notes, which matures in 4 years and bears an interest of 4% annually. Even though the fund allowed to accelerate production, this again will increase its dependency in getting the USPS contract to move forward. Workhorse recorded an interest expense over $111 million in the first half of 2020. With a $200 million funding, interest expense is definitely going to be higher. From inception, Workhorse have financed the operations primarily through issuance of debt. That to me is a deal breaker. I believe the revenue from sales should be the major contributor and debt should be used to support it. But for Workhorse, taking on more debt is its only lifeline. Workhorse in its financial statements confirms their liquidity and cash at hand. They have an approximate $26 billion in cash. They intend to raise an additional $70 million from exercising warrants. But if the stock price falls below the exercisable price of $20.90 per share, then those warrants are useless. So the $70 million from warrants are highly dependent on the stock price being about $20.90, and this heavily depends on Workhorse grabbing the USPS contract. With the cash in hand and with the funds from warrants if exercised and with the additional $200 million secured last week, Workhorse should be able to support their funding requirements into 2022. But what after that? Even if I disregard the cash flow situation, the revenue of Workhorse bothers me a lot. In the first and second quarter of 2020, Workhorse brought in a little over $176,000 in sales, and this is significantly lower than what they had in 2019 for the same period. A company in its growth phase can have zero earnings or even negative earnings, but what can explain lack of sales? Is it lack of customer interest? Factoring all of these and many more, Workhorse to me as of now looks like a speculation. Given the USPS contract and Workhorse's high valuation, I would rather be late than be wrong. Now, I would love to hear from you guys. What do you think about Workhorse and where do you think the company will be in the next 3 years? Leave a comment below with your answer and I'll be sure to follow up with you. Also, if you liked this video and found it valuable, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button. I really appreciate your support as it keeps me motivated to put in the long hours for making these videos. So until you hear from me again, stay safe and thanks for watching. Bye.